You probably saw by now lots of foggy forests that look dreamy and moody and so beautiful. And most of you, I'm pretty sure, know that my favorite place to photograph is in the forest, especially in rainy, foggy days. And because I received few questions about this type of landscape photography, I decided to record this video with 3 secret steps to help you with your foggy forest photography. Also, after you watch this video, please use the comment section below and tell me what other tips you have for this type of landscape photography. It will be great to create a long and interesting list of tips related to foggy forest photography. Most important element in this situation is, of course, the fog. The reason why the forest looks so good in foggy conditions is because first it gets rid of the chaos and the clutter, and then it makes you wonder what's beyond the fog. If the fog is too thick, the photos will not look that good because you'll only have silhouettes of trees. In this situation, the best thing that you can do is walk to the edge of the fog, and now you have a little bit of clear elements, and then you have the fog that adds the mystery and all the other stuff. If the fog is too thin, then you'll need to work harder on finding an interesting composition, and the reason for that is because you see much more from the chaos of the forest. The perfect scenario is when you have half of the image in clear and half of the image in fog. So you have a little bit of situation where you have visible and not visible, and this usually happens when the fog is starting to clear away. The problem is, in that situation, you need to move really fast. You need to be really quick because this happens just like that. So sometimes you need to basically run through the forest and just move as fast as you can with the camera. Step 2 of this video would be to find the S-curve. Finding composition in the chaos of the forest is hard, and you can mess things easily. My suggestion is to always have a look for S-curves. Usually this happens on a trail, on a dirt road that goes through the forest. You also need to have a wider trail, because if the trail is really narrow, it will not make such an interesting composition. And the perfect forest, although there is no such thing as perfect and imperfect in nature, but the perfect forest for this type of photography, the foggy forest situation, is flat. Simple. Flat forest, S-curve, a wider trail, and this is a simple recipe for success. Step 3 is to expose properly for the fog. The most common mistake is not exposing for the fog. And here is what happens. The camera sees all the white of the fog and it interprets it like this. It's too bright, so I will need to take it a little bit down. And that is why many foggy forest photos end up gray and dark and not having that something that makes it interesting. Depending on how thick the fog is, you will need to compensate and adjust your exposure. Now, if the fog is really thick and you measure the exposure on the fog, you'll usually need to overexpose, starting with half a stop, go up to one or maybe even 2 stops, but this is very rarely. What you need to remember is that the fog is the real interesting element over here, so you need to properly expose it. You'll need to have the fog in the perfect exposure to convey the feeling that you want to add to your photo. Another thing would be not to overexpose your photos, and that could very easily happen at the top of the trees where the sky is much more visible and where the sunlight is also much stronger. I hope these 3 steps were useful to your foggy forest photography, and don't forget to write a comment if you have other tips that you can add related to this topic. Also, you can support me by buying one of my editing courses, and until next time, keep on photographing. It's the only way that you can get better. Bye bye.